This Drude Lorentz theory could successfully explain conductivity, that is the conductivity in metals, okay, was explained successfully by Drude Lorentz theory, that is CFET, that is it was okay, but there were failures. So what were the failures that occurred? There were many failures, but you have two failures to be mentioned, okay. I will be mentioning only about two failures which were occurring or which resulted into the failure of classical free electron. The first failure was temperature dependence, temperature of sigma, that is how sigma related to T. How is sigma related to T, temperature? What is the relation between sigma and T? This was not successfully explained by this classical free electron theory. The reason was, so we know that we should keep in mind that any theory which is proposed, simultaneously we will be having an experimental experiments in order to explain whether the theory is correct or no. If you have an experiment, then there should be a theory to prove that whatever the experiment performed is correct or no. So we know that the conductivity sigma of a metal is inversely proportional to temperature. So this was experimentally observed. So this electrical conductivity is inversely proportional to temperature was experimentally observed, but from CFET. But CFET showed that sigma is not inversely proportional to temperature, but sigma is inversely proportional to root of temperature, and which is not correct. This was experimental and this was from CFET. So these both were not matching. So it means that the CFET failed in explaining the relation or the temperature dependence of electrical conductivity. Next, the second one was, that is the second failure. The second failure was electrical conductivity dependence on electron concentration. So what is the relation between sigma and n? How the electrical conductivity depends on the electron concentration, that is what is I said that free electrons are responsible for conduction, so that free electrons concentration is nothing but represented by n. So how is conductivity related to n? No doubt from the expression we have, sigma is directly proportional to n. Why? Because we have the expression of sigma is equal to n e square tau by m. So it means that there is a direct relation between sigma and n. So sigma is directly proportional to n. But in cases like, for example, let me consider zinc and aluminium. So n, the value of n in zinc was 13.10 into 10 to the power of 28 per meter cube, and for aluminium it was 18.06 into 10 to the power of 28 per meter cube. So this was the concentration of free electrons, that is number of free electrons present per unit volume in the case of zinc, and in the case of aluminium was in this way. So as we see that from this figure, sigma is directly proportional to n. It means that if n is more, then the conductivity is also more. So from this two I can say that aluminium is having a higher conductivity. Why? Because the concentration is more here. But it was found that okay, for other metals like copper and silver, okay, the copper had a concentration of 8.45 into 10 to the power of 28 per meter cube, and silver, that is argentum, had 5.85 into 10 to the power of 28 per meter cube. So let me compare all these four, that is zinc, aluminium, copper and silver, and their concentration. So from this two, that is copper and silver, has a concentration of 8.45 and 5.85, which is less when compared to zinc and aluminium. But it was found later that the sigma for copper and silver was higher than sigma for zinc and aluminium. So why, what was the reason for this increase in conductivity of copper and silver with lower concentration than the conductivity of zinc and aluminium with higher concentration could not be explained with the help of classical free electron theory, or they failed to explain what was the reason for this discrepancy that is caused in these materials even if the concentration is more. So this was one of the failure of classical free electron theory. Because of these failures, Sommerfeld proposed a theory called as quantum free electron theory, and whatever assumptions that were made in CFET, okay, the assumptions what were made in CFET were redefined in QFET by Sommerfeld, and then he gave his quantum free electron theory depending on Pauli exclusion principle.